Is everybody in?
Are we ready?
Let's hear it. Let's louder than that, everybody. It's Total Loop. It's December. It's almost Christmas. And you're not in class.
Thank you.
I think they're only four blocks away from just down the street, the Edmonton Christian Lions. From St. Albert, the Paul Kane Blues. And from the south side of the city, the Storks. From down Highway 2, from Red Deer, the Lindsay Thurber Raiders. From down into Hooker Town, first time contestants of King, the Lillian Osborne Legends. And from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, the Aiden Bowman, boys, the Bears. Hey, pay attention to the screens. It's all about the history, the tradition. For the singing of All Canada, can we please stand and remove our hats and toques? Thank you so much for being here. Assistant Superintendent Morrison, thank you for joining us as well. Sarah Chan, our wonderful alumni, thank you so much for being here. Athletes, thank you for honoring us and joining us on our 25th anniversary. And welcome to the greatest students and staff in the whole wide world. Welcome to the culture and spirit of We Are
Champ!
Guys, thank you so much. This tournament 25 years ago, the plan was we wanted to have an early season tournament where players could highlight their skills and coaches, you could implement some of your systems, and we wanted to build team culture and chemistry, and we wanted you to have an opportunity to have some sportsmanship and ability to just have fun. And I think 25 years, we've done the right thing. I want to say to you, please have a great time here. Play hard, play fast, play with class, and enjoy yourselves. Thanks very much for coming.
Hi there, everybody. Like last week, I was working, and Mr. Kubel mentioned that that Sarah Chan was coming today, and somebody mentioned it. Is it, what's your proper term? Is it the First Lady? That's what someone mentioned. You don't say that. Well, I'm going to tell the crowd about you. Sarah Chan is a piano teacher, a social advocate, a mother of two. Okay? Her living running a private piano studio, but she commits her life to helping build community alongside her partner, our mayor, Don Iveson. As a social advocate, Sarah leads by example, acting as a role model, an ambassador in furthering the empowerment of girls, and inspiring youth to lead throughout her community outreach. A community-minded individual, Sarah's engaged in many undertakings to help others achieve success in school and in life. She's a big sister with big brothers and big sisters, director of corporate relations for APRSI. She is an honorary patron of YES, Youth Emergency Shelters, a grateful user and supporter of the Edmonton Public Library, and a member of the mentor team at the Peter Lougheed Leadership College at U of A. She is small but mighty and a proud T-Bird. Because once a T-Bird, what's that?
Always a
T-Bird. Once a T-Bird?
Always a T-Bird.
Oh, come on, louder than that. Once a T-Bird?
Always a T-Bird.
There we go. Sarah, can you come on up?
A lot of things have changed, like this amazing renovated gym we're in. But I know there's a lot here at Chef that appears to be holding strong since my own graduation in 1998. I know, it's funny, because I don't think I'm old, but now when I go speak at schools, they're just like, that's okay. I'm okay. I'm coming to terms with it. For example, your principal, Mr. Pollage, is still here. Back in my day, I believe he was a gym and math teacher. I could be wrong, because I don't think I ever had him, but he was around. Mr. Kubel, your work experience coordinator, used to be my grade 11 IB social teacher. And that's just the faculty. The other thing that I can sense is stronger than ever is your community chef spirit here at Totem Hoop. To all your visiting students, it's kind of funny because my husband, Don's family, is like their Scona lords, and so he's like, if my kids go, they'll be like fourth generation lords, and I'm like, what's a lord? Ours is a Thunderbird. Sorry, it's really hard. I'm like at my own home, so it's... And other thing, fun fact, my husband's father, Iveson Sr., Bob Iveson, he was a student here in the 60s, and he was an art student and drew that T-Bird. So the T-Bird you guys still use today is from Mr. Iveson Sr. Yeah, cool, huh? In my early chef days, my best friend Richard, who isn't here, sat behind me in grade 10 English. We wrote the same assignments, we learned about the heart's aorta and pulmonary artery, we dissected a fetal pig in bio. I was also involved in radio club and hung out with music people. I was a floater, I don't know about you guys, I'm a floater. In addition to my IB people, who all happen to be the student council people too, I volunteer and I made some beautiful friends here, many of whom I am still close to today. The sense of community here is one of the things that I carry with me always. So I never thought I would go on to teach music like as my real job, you know, like forever. But who knew? It turns out that owning your own small business where you like play music every day is basically the best. I never thought I would do a master's degree, like where my thesis on the study of European versus North American cycling infrastructure. I never thought I'd go to the U of A and write for Gateway newspaper, where I met my husband, Don Iveson. I never knew that we would run for office, and I certainly never would have forecasted that we would run for mayor and win twice. So I've been so lucky to have the opportunity to work in our community in a way that's meaningful to me. And that means getting to work with students on tackling local poverty right here in Edmonton. It means mentoring kids and talking about all the diversity in leadership and community service. It means getting to come to share a few words with students like you, and it's truly such an honor to be here with you all. So in addition to welcoming you all to the tournament, I'm also here to tell you, yeah, it's long, but life is going to be long, and you're going to have to like sit through a lot of stuff, right? I'm also here to tell you that your life will probably take you to some unexpected places. I encourage you to embrace new things, try hard, help others, and be kind. The work Mayor Iveson and I do to build a better Edmonton is for you future leaders, and we're going to need your help. It's up to you to also speak up and act for the sort of inclusive, uplifting, modern city you want to live in. So I look forward to seeing the great things you will all do, starting with the games you're going to play this afternoon. Good luck, have fun, and thank you.
Thank you. All right.
Coming up, we are going to start our list of activities today. Now, I would like to introduce to you guys some of the most fierce, some of the most passionate basketball players you guys will meet, and these are our tiny T-Birds of 2 to 5 years old. So, introducing, we have Leah, Kiana, two teams with the most points will move on to the final round, and in the final round, the girls will have another 60 seconds to make their shots, but this time, they're playing for the prize. So, first up, we have Archbishop Jordan.
Pretty exciting here. It got real quiet though. I need to cheer on those Scots. Archbishop Jordan Scots.
Yeah. All right.
From Sherwood Park, Alberta.
So as you guys can see on the ground, there are markers for where the players can stand in terms of making their shot. So as good Shep T-Birds, we're gonna make sure that our guests feel welcome and we're gonna cheer them on. That's how we do it at Shep, right? Players in place, time is spent. 3, 2, 1.
Are you guys ready? Is the score table ready? Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, shoot!
Thank you.
nice work. Well, Mr. Feldman's gonna come up. Ben Feldman, everyone, big hand for Mr. Feldman. Mr. Feldman helped coordinate the opening ceremonies. So he'll explain what the guys are doing. Are you gonna play? Here, Mr. Feldman, I'll take the mats.
Okay, Chef, so here's what's going. What's gonna happen, this is the boys' skills competition. We're gonna put these challengers through an array of different tasks that you would find in a basketball game. Please make sure you are aware. You guys might get hit, so just watch out, keep your heads up. What's gonna happen is, each competitor, they will start right here with this ball. As soon as they grab it and go, they're making their way to this side for a layup or a dunk, whatever they like. Then they're gonna dribble through each pylon, making their way to the passing zone. The racquetballs will be right here, and they're gonna have to make, they have five attempts to try to get the pass, the chest pass through the hula hoop there. Once they get it, they will then move on to the shooting stage. They'll now shoot one free throw. It'll be basically a jump shot. They have five attempts. Once they hit it or they miss, they will then move on to this spot where they have to make the bounce pass. Once they complete the bounce pass, they're grabbing the ball and they're going through the pylons again one last time, just these three. And once they get to this last one, time is done. The player with the best time will go home the winner. So, hopefully that makes sense. Our first competitor will be from Aiden Bowman. Should be Mason Gunther. miss basketball and do the week. Okay, Zach, here we go from MT Christian. When you're ready.
Go!
It's the layup. Let's go. It's got the 4-5 on lead. Here we go. This is not easy. Here's his first pass and then it's good. Here's his jump shot. First one's good. Let's go.
I think you might know.
front of 2,500 people. Look at that. Are you getting them ready for the big dance?
Oh, yeah.
Now we know our spots. Are you ready?
My name is Scott Ellis, and I'm a former basketball player and former coach at Ross Shepherd. And I'm here today to present two scholarship awards to two very deserving Ross Shepherd basketball players. These awards are funded by two sources. First of all, the Justin J. Wong Memorial Fund, and the other is the Ross Shepherd Alumni Basketball Fund. Both are represented here today, and I'm glad to see so many folks here today. The Justin J. Wong Award was established by his parents, Virginia and Danny Wong, and in honor of their son, Justin Wong, who passed away prematurely after graduating from Ross Shepherd. Danny and Virginia are both here, and I'd like to have them stand up and have the crowd acknowledge them. You'd be interested to know that Justin had a passion for a number of sports, basketball being one of them. He was a huge supporter of the Ross Shepherd basketball teams, and extremely enthusiastic, and I think his enthusiasm spilled over, much like the enthusiasm today is spilling over, and everyone's getting behind cheering for Ross Shepherd and the other teams. Justin Miller was a true T-Bird. He approached every day with energy and class. He saw the positives in life and the positives in the people around him. I hope all of you will continue to keep his spirit alive at Ross Shepherd. The other fund source is the Ross Shepherd Alumni Basketball Fund, which was initially established by a number of former alumni, former players, who wanted to give back to the basketball program in thanks for many great memories and great friendships that were created while attending and playing basketball at Ross Shepherd. The awards are given to graduating senior basketball players, one for the men's team and one for the women's team, who showed outstanding sportsmanship, dedication, determination, leadership, both on and off the court, and average academic achievement. The award winners were selected by their coaches and from the graduating class of 2007, and they are as follows. Don Richardson Wilson, I've asked her to come up and be presented with the check. I'd just like to read a couple of words that the athletic director, Dean Walls, put together for Don. He described Don as the type of athlete any coach would love to have. First one in the gym and last one in the league, Don came to Shep with exceptional athleticism and an unparalleled world work ethic. She was an integral part of her junior city team's championship in her grade 10 year and was a key member of the senior team during her grade 11 and grade 12 years. She is honest, humble, hardworking, extremely coachable, and was last year's female athlete of the year. Congratulations, Don. You sound like you're very honored by this award, and we wish that you'll have great experiences going forward. Thank you. Congratulations, Michael. no, congratulations to the award recipients this year, and we look forward to coming back again next year and awarding them again to some future graduates. We are...
Thank you very much, Scott. Atir and Natty, can you come on up for the ceremonial dip up? And then it's going to be a ceremonial dismissal after. Hey, Mr. Feldman, you have to do this. You have to toss it up. You don't want me doing that. Maddie was really worried about this, so Maddie, do you want to like take a running start on this? You might need it, right? I think you can beat him. She's talking trash about you like the other day at practice. She was. She's like, I can take him. I can win this. So ceremonial tip off. Everybody for coming. So it's 25 years, but it's the start of 25 years more. We have a renovated gym. We're going to have a renovated school soon. Okay? But we haven't lost any spirit. We're going to kick it up. Boys play at 12:30. Guess who? Red Deer? Lindsay Thurber? Yeah, I knew that. I was wondering if you guys knew that. Girls? Take on Aiden Bowden at 2:30. All students at Chef should come down, watch them, cheer on both teams, show school spirit. Okay, and the last thing before we dismiss, there's a group that never gets thanked on things like this, and that's the leadership kids. Always behind the scenes, we made things like this work for all you athletes. They're here at 7 o'clock in the morning, they're running around, they're getting things organized, and they're great. So it always takes a village, guys. And thank you very much for all the teams who came all this way to get here. And let's have two more days of great basketball. Thank you very much. Let's have the teams exit first, and then everyone else, hopefully, exits after. Okay, let's one more big hand for all the